Azerbaijan is a country in the Caucasus region of Eurasia, and it's located at the crossroads of Eastern Europe and Western Asia. It's bounded by the Caspian Sea to the east, the Russian Republic of Dagestan to the north, Georgia to the northwest, Armenia and Turkey to the west, and Iran to the south. While around 97% of the population is Muslim, the Constitution of Azerbaijan does not declare an official religion, and all major political forces in the country are secularist. Now, Azerbaijan is a developing country, and it ranks 87th on the Human Development Index. It has a high rate of economic development and literacy, as well as a low rate of unemployment. However, the ruling party called the New Azerbaijan Party has been in power since 1993, and it's been accused of authoritarian leadership and deterioration of the country's human rights record, including increasing restrictions on civil liberties, particularly on press freedom and political repression. The official language is Azerbaijani, which is a Turkic language. Azerbaijani is spoken by approximately 92% of the population as a mother tongue. Russian and Armenia are also spoken, and each are the mother tongue of around 1.5% of the population. There are a dozen other minority languages spoken also in the country. In this video, I'm also going to give you the advantages and disadvantages of getting this residency. It leads up to a passport. Also, if you want to learn more how to legally get your taxes to zero, how to get a second passport as quick as 3 months, do three things. Hit the subscribe button to the right of your screen here. You'll get new videos as they come out automatically. And don't forget to hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button. And number two is I'd like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, just put it below and I'll get back with you, see what I can do to help solve whatever problem you got. And number three is go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com. Hit the button at the top of the homepage that says apply with us and then fill out that questionnaire. And then hit the button at the bottom that says send it to us so we can help you get started. We deal with a lot of citizenship by investment, residency by investment countries that I think you'd be interested in learning about. All right, now, health care in Azerbaijan is provided by public and private health care institutions and regulated through the Ministry of Health Care. Public hospitals are run by the state, and medical care is offered free of charge for Azerbaijani residents. Now, Azerbaijani citizens had visa-free or visa-free on arrival access to 66 countries and territories, ranking the Azerbaijani passport the 78th best passport in the world as far as travel freedom. Now, Azerbaijan does not allow dual citizenship, and anyone who voluntarily applies and obtains foreign citizenship automatically loses Azerbaijani citizenship. Now, Azerbaijani does tax worldwide income to its residents. And they define residents as people that are there for at least 183 days a year. The personal income tax rate in Azerbaijan stands at 25%. There's a corporate tax rate of 20%. The VAT is 18%. The Social Security tax is 25%. And of that 25%, there's a breakout where 22% is paid by the company and 3% is paid by the employee. Now, a foreigner or a stateless person who lives in the territory of Azerbaijan Republic for the last 5 years and submits a document certifying his or her knowledge of the state language may be admitted to the citizenship of Azerbaijan Republic upon his or her own application, as long as it's consistent with the law at that particular time. Now, to get temporary residency, all you would have to do is invest as little as 50,000 Azerbaijan manat, which is the current rate is around 30,000 US dollars, and it just needs to be deposited in a bank account. The GDP per capita of Azerbaijan is around 4,721 US dollars a year. All right, now I'm going to give you my evaluation on this program personally, and it is as follows. The GDP per capita is very low, which is good if you have a business and you want to keep your labor costs down real low. The investment to get residency is very low, but I don't like that this country doesn't allow dual citizenship. And the taxes, in my opinion, although lower than the U.S., are too high for me. I do like the fact that health care is free in the public hospitals to residents. I don't like the fact that there is a language test that you have to pass to actually get the passport and citizenship. There are very few people that speak the English language fluently in this country. So if you don't learn the Turkish dialect, you're going to be pretty frustrated. The visa-free travel at only 66 countries is really bad. Just to give you an example, a St. Kitts and Nevis passport will give you about 2.5 times more visa-free countries and territories that you can travel to, and it allows dual citizenship, and it's also an English-speaking country. St. Kitts also has no income tax, no capital gains tax, no estate or inheritance tax. The weather in the Caribbean is a lot better, too, in the world than the region that Azerbaijan is located. And also, there's no test that you have to take to get citizenship in St. Kitts. I'll be honest with you, I personally would avoid this country for residency and citizenship purposes for the following reasons that I've given you. If you want to learn more how to legally get your taxes to zero, how to get a second passport as quick as 3 months, do three things. Hit the subscribe button on the right of your screen here, and you'll get new videos as they come out automatically. And number two is I'd like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, just put it below and I'll get back with you. And number three is go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com. Hit the button at the top of the homepage there that says apply with us. Fill out that questionnaire. Then hit that button at the bottom that says send it to us. And we can help you get started. We deal with a lot of citizenship by investment and residency by investment countries I think you'd be interested in learning about. And I look forward to talking to you on the next video. Take care.